Hello everyone! In this episode I will show you how to create a list of necessary plywood for our projects using Sketchup and the OpenCutList plugin. If you feel like this tutorial contains information beyond your understanding of Sketchup, I recommend accessing the link in the description that will take you to the complete playlist with all the episodes you need. Let's get started and create a component as I showed you in the previous episodes. I will choose some easy to remember dimensions. Let's create a plywood sheet with dimensions of 1000 by 500 millimeters and the most common thickness, which is 18 millimeters. Very important, don't forget to select Make Component. We don't assign any characteristics now, just select Create. Let's see what list OpenCutList exports now. We open the plugin, select Parts, followed by Generate. We found the component with our dimensions, but we see that it does not have a defined material. A little higher up, we will always see instructions for exporting a complete and correct list. Here we are notified that we have not assigned a material type to the component. This can be done either from SketchUp or from OpenCutList. From now on, I will refer to the plugin as OCL because most users do this and I don't want to waste too much time. Let's get more familiar with SketchUp and its functions for now. To assign a material, we obviously go to the Materials menu. If the default tray menu is not active, you already know from other episodes that we select Entity Info to activate it. We scroll up to the Materials menu. Now, we either assign a predefined material that comes with the program, or we create a new material. Let's create a new material because we haven't done that yet. We select this icon called Create Material, name the material whatever we want, for example, Wenge plywood, and choose a color from this color palette. This color can be made darker or brighter from the bar on the right. I think this is the closest color to Wenge. But what if we want a color with a texture that looks as close to reality as possible? It's very simple. We go to our browser, search for Wenge plywood, and download an image in JPEG or PNG format. Then we go back to SketchUp and check Use Texture Image. A browse box opens, we go to our image and open it. And we have created our first material. Remember, if you get lost in the default tray menu and can't find this material anymore, just go to Materials and select the icon with the house drawing, titled In Model. All newly created materials in the model will be found here. Similarly, for the created components, you can find them under Components in the In Model menu. We go back to Materials, click on our newly created material. See that the Paint Bucket tool has been automatically activated and use it to assign the desired material to our component. Just a small adjustment here for a nicer texture. If we go back to OCL now, we see that we haven't completely solved the problem. We have the color and name of the component, but the plugin doesn't know what type of material it is. For this, either we go to the Materials menu and edit its characteristics, or we select Edit the material directly from the Component Summary menu. I prefer the second option. Click the pencil and a box opens where we can change the name and color of the material. I won't change anything and we'll go straight to the Type menu. From here we select Sheet Goods, which are goods that come in sheets or panels. Now, for reasons I will explain in other episodes, I recommend either keeping one of the predefined thicknesses or, if you want a different thickness, you can enter it manually. Below, we select the dimensions of the panel to be cut. Here, just like above, I recommend either keeping or manually entering only one of the options. We select Apply and notice that we no longer have question marks and that we have assigned a material recognized by OCL to our component. Now that we have done this, we can create the cutting diagram. However, let's create more panels so our project looks like a piece of furniture and to better understand the final cutting diagram. We repeat the same commands and now we just need to assign the already created material and OCL will automatically recognize that the components are part of a sheet of Wenge plywood. Now I would like to make a few remarks that I consider extremely important. If we did not create a component correctly, when we apply the material, it will only be applied to one side. Also, if we do not create a component, it will not be found in the list generated by OCL. If we hide one of the components, as I taught you in another episode, again, the component will not be found in the list generated by OCL. So don't forget to make them visible again. If you do not select any components, OCL will export the list for the entire project or model, as Sketchup calls it. If, on the other hand, you only select some components in the model, OCL will only include those components in the list. In our future projects, you will see that this is extremely useful. Now we are ready to export our list for a piece of furniture. Select cutting diagram and, if necessary, modify cutting parameters such as trimming size or the thickness of the blade used for cutting. Apply generate, and here is our first cutting diagram. It comes with a lot of details about each component. The most important one for the price evaluation is the number of sheets. Here we only have one, but depending on the dimensions and number of sheets we need, the required large plywood sheets will be adjusted. OCL will optimize the cuts so that the material waste is minimal. Excess material is represented by these X's. Now you can print the diagram on paper or export a PDF file. So, whether you cut the pieces from smaller plywood sheets yourself or place an order for this service with a specialized company, now you have everything you need. OCL also has the function of printing labels to mark each required component during assembly. There is much more to talk about SketchUp and OpenCutList, but I believe that after seeing this tutorial, you have a much better understanding of what the plugin was created for and the most basic settings and functions required. In the next episode, we will see how to introduce the all-important edge bandings into the material list and cutting diagram, so that you can move on to building your desired furniture while making considerable savings. The administrator of the DIY Workshop channel thanks you for watching, and only if you like the tutorial invites you to subscribe to the channel for free to be notified of new tutorials, to like or share the tutorials with other friends passionate about such projects. Only in this way can the channel thrive and continue to generate extremely useful content. Goodbye.